Hey folks, what's going on? Welcome to another edition of Let's Intelli Play. I'm your host, Josh Boykin, the founder of Intelligame.us, a game culture and criticism site where we find intersections between games and the world around us. I am glad that you were able to make it for yet another week. Sorry that we started a little bit behind schedule this time around. We've got some construction that's going on the house, and that has kind of thrown things a little bit out of whack. You may notice, actually, that you hear some construction sounds over the course of the stream. We're still going ahead and tuning up, making sure that they're doing, you know, quality, safe work. So thank you to the folks who are helping to make this place stable and all of those good things. And in the meantime, so here we are. And what's up, Black Bat? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, you're here at... right here at the beginning too, 5 o'clock, I guess, probably 8 o'clock your time. So it's good to see you. I hope you've had a good week. How has, you know what? Actually, that's a really ridiculous statement to make because all of our weeks have been pretty. It's been a week, really. Also, thanks for that follow, Eolin. 08, welcome to the stream. It's good to see you. To be truthful, though, I am trying to approach today with some positivity because I always look forward to Let's Intelli Play. It's been kind of a garbage week, and the weekend was one of the most garbage of weekends. The idea that we are now at a state where we can have large-scale white supremacy rallies to the point that that Heather Heyer or anybody could be run over and killed in counter-protest while attempting to stand for and support inclusion and diversity and respecting people. That's a really shitty way to start any week. And the idea, particularly, that we have seen some of the really either exceptionally milquetoast or just outright blatantly offensive rhetoric that has come out of the White House, an outright failure to truly denounce any of these reprehensible behaviors, or then to even backpedal from both sides to, well, what about the alt-left? I really can't abide that rhetoric one bit. We actually talked a little bit on Intelligame Radio about the nature of the linguistic play that was the what about the alt-left. And it is shocking some of the linguistic tools that have been brought into play by somebody who we commonly write off as being not particularly sharp, but I don't think you get that rich by being dumb. And I don't think that the people who he's brought in his cabinet or his administration are dumb either. So it's great that we've seen some folks galvanized and getting ready to stand up for folks' rights and for what they believe in. We've seen a massive outpouring of support, and so that helps. I had no idea that you were that close to Charlottesville, Black Bat. That's overwhelming. I can't imagine how that must feel. I'm sorry. When I was actually living outside of St. Louis, I was probably about a half hour away from Ferguson when the protests were beginning for Mike Brown, and you can watch things on the news, but there's a certain level of gravity that comes to having it in your backyard that is hard to truly explain or understand. So I'm definitely wishing you the best. Also, Eric, welcome to the stream. It's been good to see you on Intelligame Radio. It was nice to be able to chat a little bit about the SNES versus Sega debate and whatnot. It's been really awesome to see you get active there, and I'm glad that you are becoming more, more active in the Intelligame community. It's good to have you. Oh my gosh, an hour from Baltimore. Like, there's, you know, it's interesting that you say that. There's nowhere you can be distant in this country, and that makes sense because it has not been. It's not as if it used to just happen in small isolated pockets, right? The folks who are perpetrating this, the white supremacists, the Nazis, the people who are stepping out and doing this kind of garbage activity, they've always been there. It's just now that they feel emboldened by the current administration, and not only the administration, but a number of situations that have been created outside of it to be able to take some of these more shocking actions. And so it makes sense that it feels like the walls are kind of closing in, because to a certain extent, they are, not in the sense that they are now everywhere. It's just that the actions are taking place in more places, and the actions are more blatant, and we also have more tools with which to document when these actions are happening. So I am hoping that I'm hoping that there will be ways that this turns into something positive. I'm still convinced that folks who stand for justice and for tolerance and for anti-fascism, I'm still convinced that we are the exceptional majority. This is not a question of it. You know, it was interesting. I was thinking about the idea of how people talked about, well, the silent majority stood up and voted for. Well, I mean, that's not how that worked, because there were almost 300 or almost 3 million people who voted the other direction. So I don't think that this is a question of numbers. I think this is a question of influence. And I think that there are a number of us who are, I think it's very easy to get scared in these situations, and for good reason. There's a lot to be worried about. But I also think that we can find strength and confidence in each other and find ways to stand up for what we believe in any number of ways. Some of it, you know, is people going direct on the front lines of protest. But some of it is, it's smaller scale. It's doing the writing. It's doing the reinforcements. It's packing lunches. It's being a decent person. It's being willing to have the conversations. It's being willing to step out when somebody has said something that does not abide. We're all going to have to find ways to step just a little bit out of our comfort zones to be able to push the needle back in the right direction. And we'll have to see how that all plays out. Anyway, so I am going to go ahead and get a couple of things fixed here. It looks like we had a interestingly silent intro. We usually have the music playing in the background, and I apparently didn't tweak one of the settings that I needed to be able to get the music playing where it needed to. So that's okay though. That means that none of that prior talk will have gotten muted, which is really exciting. So today we are going to attempt to rewrite history ever so slightly. We are going to be playing The Political Machine. It's actually, let's go ahead and update, because right now we're not playing Tacoma. Though Tacoma was really fun. I hope that folks enjoyed that last week. And thanks again to Steve Gaynor and all the folks over at Fulbright who not only were willing to give us a key for the game so that we could play it, but also through a really fantastic launch party. And Steve actually reached out and said, yeah, you know, it'd be cool to be on Let's Intelliplay sometime and to have a discussion. So hopefully we'll be able to have him here on the show and talk about some of the ways that they created the narrative and the story and the situations in Tacoma. But today, yes, it is apropos. We are going to try and get a new president. So let's update to Let's Intelliplay. We're running for president. The Portable Machine 2016. There we go. Hey, what's up, Chim? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, hopefully we won't have to go full Illuminati to be able to get a chance to be the winners. You know, before we get kicked off, I wonder if emojis show up on the live feed. There's actually a plugin that some people have so that when you do an emoji, it like hovers in the middle of the chat or whatever. And I'm going to have to figure out, I think there's a way to do that, but at least emojis do show up in the little chat box over on the right hand side of the screen. I do want to make a quick announcement, though I think so far most of the folks in here will know. So Intelligame has been running for almost the past 2 years completely out of my pocket. And we have done a lot of really awesome stuff together building this this space and this community. And I've particularly been really inspired by the actions that we took for the Extra Life live stream and really spending time here on Twitch in general. It's been a really great sort of energy boost. So I just attended museum camp last week. It is a 2.5 day sort of like change making seminar networking experience. It was a really awesome opportunity down at the Museum of Art and History in Santa Cruz. And I want to say thanks to Nina Simon and to all of the Santa Cruz Museum of Art and History staff and the museum camp staffers who made that a really cool experience. I got to sleep overnight in a museum, folks. Like, I know they made a movie about it, and like, as far as I know, nothing came to life, but it was still really fun. It was really cool. So let's see. All I need is a hat emoji. I don't know if there's a hat emoji. We'll have to figure that out. But I did want to announce, and many of you folks have already seen it, that we are now on Patreon. This is Intelligame. I'm trying to reach out and grow the space, but I'm going to need help to be able to keep this moving. I've been running that out of pocket for almost the past 2 years, and I'm really hoping to broaden the reach of Intelligame and what it does, and I need your help to do it. So let me go ahead and put the link in here. Actually, you can type !donate, and it gives you all the information you need. But for folks who have gotten involved, who have already stepped up and donated, thank you so much. It's been amazing to watch this first goal that we already cleared. We are up to, well, let me check. Let me pull open the page real fast, and then we'll get started trying to run for office, because I know that's what everybody is here for. So we are currently at, oh, whoa, it's actually changed since the last time I was here. Oh, this is exciting, folks. So if you look at, let me see if I can get this pulled up. So if you look at this screen here, this is the Intelligame Patreon page. We now have 14 patrons, and shout out to, I don't know if folks want me to call them out by name or if they want to stay anonymous or whatnot, but this is the Intelligame Patreon page, and I am really proud and thankful for everybody who has stepped up and become part of this fundraising effort. Obviously, like, folks should not feel like they have to do this to be part of the community. But there are some really cool perks that I'm hoping to be able to offer for people who can take part in this. So we're going to be launching the Intelligame Game Club, which will be a game of the month experience, essentially, where we'll go through and have discussions about a game. And we'll have just a curated time where we can talk and choose a game every month to go through. And then we also, I'm going to be launching the Intelligame Monthly Zine, which will be like a little 8-page foldable zine that'll come to you right in your mailbox and not be a bill, which is, I'm actually really excited about that. I've got no graphic design skills. I have no idea how that's going to turn out, but I've wanted to do some physical media for a while, and I think it'll be a really cool way to start off a new project. And thank you, Jim, for calling me out for generating quality content. You're way too kind. And thank you for being a patron. That is, it's been really cool. This is a really awesome experience. I'm looking forward to seeing how this goes. If you care about the work that happens here at Intelli Game, I really hope that you'll at least share the page with other folks who this is important, who this could be important to. Yeah, and that's basically what we're going to do. We're going to keep this train moving, and I'm really excited to see where our second year comes up to. Intelligame's second birthday is at the end of September or the beginning of October, depending on how you translate. Like the first Intelligame post was posted on October 1, but the site was basically launched and like existed on September 30. So I'll have to figure out. I have to choose one. But anyway, yeah, so that's where that stands. And again, thanks everybody for being part of that. So we are now that we've gotten all the formality out of the way, we are going to jump into the political machine. Now, true confessions, we're all going to be learning how to run for office together. I have found out about this game a while ago. Actually, there was a Political Machine 2012 that came out, which I can admit that I was far more inspired by. It's really interesting looking at actually the Steam page for the Political Machine 2016. They did an update on 10.6, and this basically allows, they created updates in real time to modify like the odds and the situations that happen in the game based on things that were actually happening in the election. So the updates that they did for like 1.3, 1.31 had a lot to do with Hillary's emails, which is interesting. Their last update in recent news says, "We're almost to election day. It seems like Hillary might coast to victory, but the recent batch of emails may knock her out." And I'm not going to read the rest of it because I feel like, with that being their last update, they were just like, "Yeah, we're not really interested in dealing with this anymore." And I wasn't either. So we're going to go ahead and open this up. Make our transition real quick. Oh, this isn't one of those games that like runs in a windowed mode, so it's just gonna like drop. This is what we want. Come on, you can do this. Done. All right, so we're gonna close you and then reopen you. The Slytherin in Black Bat is going to take us further than our Ravenclaw tendencies. Yeah, I feel like I may even feel inspired to just burn the whole thing to the ground. You're just like, yeah, do you know how this could play out? Do you want that as an option? But yeah, so this is basically, it's sort of a board game. We're going to go through and we're going to create our candidate. We're going to establish a platform. And then we're going to, and then once we've done that, we're going to go and figure out, I guess, how to win running for office. Because somebody needs to figure that shit out. All right. And then don't forget, actually, don't let me forget. I'm gonna go ahead and set a timer. At 7:30, we are going to jump over. We're gonna drop the political machine and jump over to the Spawn on Me podcast. My buddy Khalif Adams, along with Cicero Holmes and Sharif Jackson, run a podcast that you definitely should be listening to every week, where they talk about games and game-related news and whatnot. This week, they're actually gonna have Austin Walker from Waypoint Media, which is Vice Media's gaming arm. They're gonna have him on the show, and I think that particularly given this weekend's events, they're gonna have some really important discussions. So I am happy and proud to have us jump over to to jump over to their stream and have some discussion and engage there. I think you all will really enjoy it. And I would say that you should check it out every week, except for some reason they decided to go ahead and go at 7:30 on Thursdays, right in the middle of my stream. I'm not taking it personally, but whatever. So I'm gonna go ahead and set a little reminder here. So at 7:20, we're gonna go ahead and take our essentially mid-session break. And that'll give me a chance to get started and get some drinks and all that. How black can we make this candidate? Not Vanta Black. Yeah, only one person can be Vanta. Only one licensed Vanta Black. All right, folks, let's check this out. All right, so campaign 2016. A new terrorist threat, a still contentious healthcare reform package, and new domestic issues have tempers flaring across the political spectrum. Get ready to lie, cry, pander, and slander your way to victory. All right, so it looks like we can have as long as a 52-week campaign. We're going to run a 21-week, and we'll start with 100% funds. I don't know what that means. And we're also going to make it easy because we don't actually know what's happening here. I don't want to do any of these randomized things. I think this will be kind of interesting to keep. Again, they've made updates to this game based on how they felt the actual election and political climate was. So I think it'll be really kind of cool to see how we can deal with those situations ourselves. All right, so here we get the opportunity to make our candidate. We can actually run Michelle Obama. Who I wish could have actually run. It is interesting as we scroll how many of these faces are very pale. Mitt Romney is about as dark as many of these folks come. All right, so we got Michelle Obama here. Oh, Herman Cain. We forgot about, does Isima let you collude with Russia? Like, yeah, apparently that's an easy way to win. Let's see. Ben Carson. We got Herman Cain, Condoleezza Rice. How did this happen, folks? How did this happen? There's the old Barry O. First black president. Obama was elected in 2008 and served his second term in 2012. His tenure is known for its signature healthcare reform package, as well as its difficult relationship with Congress. Ajamu Baraka is a tireless human rights activist. He joined the Green Party to start an international movement to address the needs of working people, and yet they write him up as a Democrat. Yeah. All right, so wait, do we want to actually run Michelle, or do we want to do a custom candidate? Because we can make our own, or we can try and lead Michelle Obama to victory. I'll give it a second. Let's see, what does custom let us do? Yeah, well, let's take a look. We'll see. New. Here we go. So we can come up with a party. It only lets us run Democrat or Republican. This game's like, yeah, the third party, not even a choice. Not even an option. All right, so yeah, we're not running a repub, sorry. Make you, but with a bow. No, the pink bow. I shouldn't say this on stream. It's gonna happen one day. I know it's gonna happen one day. Anyway, all right. let's see. Where do we want? We want a bow emote. Yeah, one day we'll have to. I am actually considering taking the Twitch affiliate role. And if I do that, then we will have some custom emotes. If not, I think we can load custom emotes with the Better Twitch TV extension, which we'll talk about another time. Let's see. So right now, Intelligame is based out of Portland, Oregon. So I think we're going to make that our home state. Customized figurehead. You have not changed your candidate's name. Oh, okay. What do we want to name our candidate, folks? Can you? I hope not. I think. Well, let's test. Customize figurehead. Okay, yeah, and we do have the option to change to actually change the way our candidate looks. Whoa. That's terrifying. Intelli Game. All right, folks, I'm down with that. All right, so we're going to run the Intelligame candidate. We are getting Intelligame is going to be our new president. Last name Game, first name Intella. That would be a really hard rap. That would be really hard. The cat eyes. All right, so let's start with the body here. We've got the evil armor. A dinosaur? That doesn't look like a dinosaur costume. Looking kind of grungy. Okay, so we can change the color of the there's a lot of customization in here. Well, we're obviously going to have to go black and yellow, folks. You knew that was coming. All right, so we've got we should actually go with a black shirt and a yellow jacket, right? Why does that none of that looks right? All right, I'm going to search and we're going to see if we can find a bow. I guess you made that easier than I anticipated. But thank you for the compliment too, Black Bat. I'm seeing a number of hats, but none of them seem to be bows. Propeller hat. And you folks are way too nice to me. A doctor's mirror thingy. All right. Well, first off, we're gonna take care of. Where's my skin tone? Here we go. That seems good. All right. And I'm sure this is the part where I get disappointed by the lack of hairstyles. That's not bad. Oh, that's not bad. Actually, can I change you? Can I adjust hat? There's a lot of customization on this. We could spend all day here. Yeah, bald does seem to be generally the default black hairstyle. It's like, nope, you didn't give us a tycoon's hairstyle. Come on, folks, don't buy into that. Come on. All right, let's see. Hair color. Make that black. So we could go with this one, or we can go with bald. Yeah, since they don't really have like the low cut. Man, that is like a six head four head, like the hairline. That is real. Wow. Okay. Yeah, I'm feeling it too. Let's keep it. We got some eyebrows here. Gotta get the facial hair. Gotta get the facial hair. Get that going. I'm usually not the person who's like all about the character creator, but I'm kind of feeling it. All right. Yeah, let's keep hatless, which is weird. And I back in school, I used to be real big on hats, but all right. I trust this person. I trust this person more than who we've got in office right now. What is this? Okay. If we make the halo pink, it's like a bow. I can abide with that. Can we change the color of the, let's see, size. I don't even see it though, is the thing. Oh, so this is per item. Okay, so we can. That's awkward. The girth of the halo girth. We can change the size of it. That now this just looks like a portal to some alternate dimension, which I could use right now. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think unfortunately we can't change the color. I think we might have to let it go. The biggest pink, if I could get you a pink bow, I would give you the pink bow you deserve, but alas, unless until they allow custom items in here, I think we'll just have to do without. All right, so let's see, we've got the facial hair, we've got the hair, we've got the Let's check. We've got some noses we can choose from. Do that one, bring it down a little bit. But not like in the mustache, that's weird. Yeah, that is true. They don't really give us the opportunity for something working outside of the gender binary. Yeah, because they only give us male and female, which is not great. I would hope that they would give us some. Oh, wait. Colors for accessories. Jacket, pants, shirts, shoes. I would hope that they would come up with a system that would make it a little more responsive outside of the gender binary for character creation in the future. I mean, because even actually the idea of just not having a male-female checkbox, like just give me. Like just. Give me a list of like hairstyles and facial types and like maybe that would and that should work just as well. Like I shouldn't have to classify a body type or sliders or whatever based on gender. Let's see. I don't necessarily. Oh, that's kind of nice. I don't know why I'm so invested. I don't know. That's okay. That's what this is for, right? Snazzy sweater vest because nobody teases the guy in the sweater vest. Oh, it looks kind of stretched on your screen, folks. We're gonna fix that in a little bit. Tough guy. You like the suit? You feeling the suit? All right, we can do that, and we'll keep the pink accents since we don't have an opportunity for a pink bow. I think this works, folks. Are we feeling good? 'Cause that creeps me out, and I'm not okay with that. I'm gonna veto that. We can find some different eyes. Wow, that just looks tired, and that looks like straight out of Charlie Brown or something like that. No, oh. No, we don't want no eyes. Where are the eyes we just had? Yeah, those cat eyes are freaking me out. I can't do that. Old eye, beady eye. We just had. I guess those. Let's do. I don't want them to be sad eyes. I mean, even though we are entering into the political spectrum, so there is probably something to be sad about. Let's do. Where is it? We'll take the eyes on the prize. Eyes on the prize. Come on. I guess we'll just maybe the sad is the default. Maybe that's their tell something they're telling us. Maybe that's the message we're supposed to be taking away from all this. In order to enter into the political spectrum, you must have sad eyes. Look at that cheesy grin. I'm feeling that. I'm feeling that. Ah! This is great. I didn't expect this character creator to be so in depth. That's not how sunglasses work, generally. What are we thinking, folks? Do we want the sunglasses or do we want to trust this person completely? Do we want to keep the sunglasses? I feel like the sunglasses kind of add to our attempt to. Is that a domino mask? Which this one? Wow, that's like a cyclops. Granny vision. Monocle, Monicle. No, that's not how that's spelled, but it's okay. So hot, yet so cool. Liking the glasses? I like the sunglasses. Let's be the cool president. Let's do this. We can make this happen. All right. Man, that is a lot of text on that bot. That was. I'm gonna have to fix that. Oh, woo. Those are some real thick glasses. All right, folks. I think we might be in business here. I think Intelli Game is ready to run for office. We're looking sharp. I think we can take a snapshot. Make snapshot larger. Use arrow keys to move snapshot. There we go. Man, that if that's the representative of the Democratic Party, we are not feeling great. You just answered a question for me that I was thinking about the other day, Black Bat. So like in situations where take snapshot. Do it. There we go. So in situations where like a surname, or is it a surname, is being used, but you're using a non-binary reference, like how do you say that? If somebody came up to me and I was like, is it MX? Like future president game. But yeah, I meant to look that up. I literally was thinking about that yesterday. If you know, that would be really cool information to share. All right. We're saving our Intelli Game candidate here, so in case we need to like go back, we can. But I think we're looking pretty snazzy. We got this down. We are ready.
He's a little bit super tiny, but a giant head.
So how would you pronounce it? Would you say like MX or like I had almost thought that like mixer, like it would use the same and, but that mixer is a word. So this is my secret career as a voice actor, folks. Yeah. Max or okay, Max or Mix. Cool. That's good to know. 'Cause I've got particularly for like non-binary friends, I want to make sure that I'm being respectful of that. So, all right, let's make this happen, folks. That's not even an option. Like, if Black Lives Matter is and it's the first thing on the platform dais, that no, that's greatly favor. Yeah. One day I'll get back into what is the show? Rick and Morty. I haven't caught up with anything lately, but okay, so it looks like we've got all sorts of stuff to do here. We've got 10 points that we can add into our characteristics. Let's add a little bit of charisma. I'll give myself some credit there. A little some credibility. We've talked about credibility. I'll give myself some appearance points. Increases the effectiveness of interview appearances. Let's also do some stamina. It looks like this costs two, each of these costs 2 points. So these must be some pretty significant factors in the game. So let's add some stamina because we want to not burn out. And let's also do some fundraising points because we want to make sure that we can like keep the engine going. We got 1 point left. So how was the game while we designed a character? Yeah, that's about where we're at right now, but it's fun, right? So let's see. We also, are you going to let me change the... I don't want it to be all like stretched out and weird for you folks. I can't tell. Maybe it's not. Oh no, that looks fine. That looks fine. Yeah. All right. And then let's see. Do we want to add a point to charisma, appearance, or credibility? Can we reduce some other things like Nick's money and become the most attractive candidate ever? I feel like if we do that, we would be setting ourselves up for sure failure. But we could cut some money. I'd be cool with cutting some money and adding a little bit to one of our other sliders if we want to do that. In the meantime, let's look at some of the issues that they talk about as platform issues for this particular election. Again, like actually, you know, if Black Bat is our campaign manager, we should probably stick with their assessment. We do need money. Well, we could be less. I am willing to add our couple points that we had here into appearance. I'll take that as a compliment. So thank you. We're just going to need to do all sorts of interviews. We're going to do one here. We're going to do a charisma point so that we can have some effectiveness on speeches and ads. And we've got one more point left. I'm thinking we should put it in fundraising. All right, you folks, let me know how you feel about this. And let's look through the stuff that they decided were platform issues. So we have specific stances that we can take on having... I don't know what this means. Points in what, though? All right, so strong military, abortion rights, addressing high gas prices, addressing climate change, bathroom bill. We're not about that. Kennedy wasn't broke, though. Let's see. Supporters say that the laws are necessary to discourage predators. Others feel the laws needlessly discriminate against members of the transgender community who wish to use the bathroom that matches their gender identity. Yeah, I'm not about a bathroom bill. Kennedy wasn't pro. I love this discussion. All right, so strong military. Supporters feel that costs of keeping such a massive military are worth it for the unique benefits of protecting national interests and determining global policy. Opponents feel that these significant resources can be better spent elsewhere. I kind of feel, man, this is weird, like actually having to take some stances here on the stream. Why are you not giving me, you're not letting me move the sliders? Yeah, so we're definitely in favor of Black Lives Matter. That's not a question. Why aren't you letting me move the other sliders? This is strange. Like, so it'll let me... It looks like everything has to add up to zero. Oh, so we have 100 points to distribute, it looks like. And if we... divvy out 50 points here and here, then we can't take them in other places. But if we find, yeah, because we can't even oppose a situation apparently without putting points into it. Okay. Yeah. So, yeah, Chim, you've got it right. So we're essentially saying how much of our platform is dedicated to blank. But the game will let us go to 50%. So let's look at what the issues are. We have Black Lives Matter, strong military, abortion rights, climate change, bathroom bill, Dakota Access Pipeline, curbing Russian might, Confederate flag display. How am I supposed to choose from all this? Like, I feel like if we were just like the blackest candidate, it'd be like, yeah, Black Lives Matter, Confederate flag display, drone warfare, drought assistance, election integrity, ending human trafficking. Like, there's so much stuff in here that you realize, like, all of these are mechanics of coming up with a national platform. The Iranian nuclear deal, like, more money for education, obviously, for that. NSA surveillance, probing Hillary's emails. Wow. NSA surveillance, outsourcing of jobs, reducing unemployment, repealing Obamacare, resettlement of refugees, saving the bees. Saving the bees is a platform issue. Student loan reform, support for Israel, supporting gay marriage, like Social Security. I'm hoping that what'll happen is as the game plays out and we get questions about these things, we'll be able to shape our platform as the game continues. Because it wouldn't make sense to not have these things over the course of gameplay. So let's pick some stuff that we want to have an initial platform in. 50 to Black Lives Matter and 50 to bees. Video game violence. Wait a second. Video games like this one make people like you mindlessly kill each other all the time, or perhaps they don't. The research is sparse and incomplete, and public debate rests heavily on unsubstantiated claims. Some people want access to video games to be restricted, especially amongst young children. Opponents will flip out and kill you right now for saying that, and feel that such heavy-handed regulation is inappropriate. Dang. Well, this... game made a statement, huh? Like, they were like, no, we just want this in here so we can say some stuff. Gotta save the bees. They share your color scheme. That's true. We gotta step up for the bees. All right, so 50% Black Lives Matter, 50% gay. But there are so many different ways to stand up for like gay rights in this one. I mean, like, you've got, oh, where do we start? All right, here's what we're gonna do. We are gonna run 50 Black Lives Matter because especially after this, like, no, I'm not gonna, and we're not gonna have these discussions about people trying to draw parallels between. Actually, there was a segment that I recorded on Intelligame Radio where we talked about the idea where people are trying to put parallels between Black Lives Matter and the Nazi Party, and that is a ridiculous smokescreen game. That is terrible. Let's also put some points into... Let's take the other points that we've got and put them in... We're going to put them in the bees. We're going to put some in the video games and some in... There is one for gay marriage, right? Gun rights. Strong military. Bathroom bill. National anthem protest. Protecting net neutrality. I'm all about that. Reducing unemployment. Okay, there it is. Supporting gay marriage. We can have space bees. And okay, all right. Let's divvy this up. Let's divvy this up. We've got 50 points. Let's do. We are going to take a stance on climate change. And we're going to take one on the bathroom bill. If you folks have something that you like, definitely want us to take a stand on, put it in the chat, and then we can figure out a way to make Intelli Game stand for what we all want to stand for. Can we still greatly favor without being at 50? Okay, so 41 is our min for greatly favor. We can do War on Terror, supporting gay marriage, do some support there. Let's see. State unions? What does that? Okay. Social Security, securing the borders, saving the bees. Got to get some of that bee rep in there. Protecting net neutrality. I got to get some in there. The emails. Can we please, for real, like. When ordered to turn. I mean, I like that they're staying relatively neutral with this description, but. Yeah, it's difficult to figure out what to stand for. Like, especially this is just our first run, so we don't really know how any of this is actually going to affect the gameplay. And it's hard to also then imagine, like, actually dividing a platform between like tons of different stuff. Cause yeah, I mean, like, we could just like stand for the bees, like bees and Black Lives Matter, and just see what happens. Do some Confederate flag. NASA. All right, we can do NASA. Funding NASA. We got some support there. I'm sure I've missed something. Abortion rights, Confederate flag display. We did the bathroom ban, or we did the bathroom bill, right? Okay, we should oppose that. Okay, so we've got Black Lives Matter as high as we can, or as low as we can for greatly favor, so we have points for other places. We slightly favor addressing climate change. We oppose the bathroom bill. What? Oh, no, that's the opposite of how I feel. Yeah, that's not, like, why would I? That makes no sense. Let's see if we can. So we are opposing the Confederate flag display. We've got funding NASA, we're in favor of. We are opposed to probing the emails because really, we are in favor of net neutrality. We are saving the bees. And let's see, we are supporting gay marriage. Let's save a couple points here. Did we miss anything? They're strongly Black Lives Matter. For some reason, they want to display Confederate flags. Yeah, because it's history, right? I'm just supporting history. That's no traditional values. The War on Terror, Wall Street regulation. Yeah, I think. All right, I think we're good. Are we good, folks? I can do that. I favor Wall Street regulation. I mean, we're taking a stance on traditional values. All right. I think we're good to go, folks, because it is 6:14 and we may not even get a chance to play the game. All right. Let's see if they give us a summary of our platform. Yeah. There we go. Let's Mandela effect where we have a Shazam. It's only I'm gonna get a soundboard so that I can play a sound effect every time the Mandela effect comes up on the Intelligame stream, because it is critical. I'm about to ban you. Please clap. It's the worst. Yeah, you're about to get banned. Black Bat on that cilantro stuff, that's not okay. You know that's not okay. We've only got 5 minority appeal. I guess at least they don't make an assumption. We're also from Oregon. So yeah, there's a lot of stuff in here that wasn't in the creator experience, intelligence, media bias, minority appeal, religious. I don't even know what we could have changed to actually get access to any of this. Oh, there was more down here. You're so alone without people. Yeah, you need to find your friend on that cilantro stuff, because I ain't helping you. I didn't realize that there's a slider here, so we should lower the religious tip just a bit, but we are going to increase that minority appeal. Media bias: how much the press likes your candidate, which can sway independent voters. Increases the responses available during an interview. Experience. Easier to win endorsements. Man, there's a lot of stuff in here to choose from, folks. I'm down for upping the intelligence a bit. Yeah, since we're Intelligame, that's fair. Why are you hating on Ravenclaw over there? It's okay. You can have a little bit of envy. That's fine. I don't necessarily have. We're a political outsider. But that's okay, because people like us. And we still look good. People trust us. Let's see. Yeah, let's give that point back there. That's all right. One day you'll need to do research and you'll know where to find us. That's all right. All right, so I think we're set. We've got still neutral on the media bias, but we're trying to reach out a little bit more to folks of color, various minorities. We have a little less experience in the industry, but that's okay. We're still brand new. We're also cutting down some of the religion, because we might not be super into it, but have a knowledge of it and appreciate it. I think we're good. I totally misread what that statement was about the libraries, and then read the following statements and was... Yep, okay. Yep, just so long as we're all on the same page. Let's play the game. Okay. So it looks like we have to pick a specific person we are running against. I really don't know that I feel comfortable about creating a world in which Donald Trump can even potentially become president. And though there's a part of me that wants to run, that wants to run against Trump. It feels a little ridiculous. Let's check these stat summaries, right? We've got apparently a lot of stamina, very little credibility, moderate intelligence, low media bias. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. If we create a custom character, we will never actually play this game. Like, yeah, because it's already 619. Yeah, I don't want to see that happen again, even in a game. I can't take it. Oh, what's up, Fluff? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, we could run against Rick Perry. I can't deal with a world where there's a part of me that's like, well, I mean, if we run against Ben Carson, at least one way or another, there's a black president, but I can't. I don't think I can deal with that. Paul Ryan is somebody who used to live in Wisconsin. Fuck Paul Ryan. Not down. Oh, Sarah Palin. Well, she's the governor of Alaska. Oh. Ron Paul. Look at the little side cocky Rick Perry. Mike Huckabee. Oh man, there are so many of these folks are just like really frustrating to even see here. John Kasich. Serious PTSD looking. It seriously, this list hurts, right? Like, you look at these and I'm like, well, if I had to lose, who would I be okay with losing to? And I'm just not comfortable with a lot of these options. I'm not. little Chris Christie. Is it with the little angry mouth too? Lose to Gary Johnson. I don't aim to lose. Intelligame aims to win. We're out of divination cookies. I forgot to get new divination cookies. I should have done that. I do have dice though. All right, so we're gonna roll a... All right, so I'm gonna look at the names that we got in the list. All right, everybody pick a character. It's okay if you pick the same ones or whatever. Just pick a character and we will roll a die and we will let fate decide. So, and I am going to override Donald Trump. Sorry, nobody gets that chance. Carly Fiorina. Carly Fiorina is an option. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. All right, we've got a Gary Johnson. We've got a Jeb Bush. Who else we have in here? Condoleezza Rice. We got a Ben Carson. Okay, so we have the black against black, but without the Godfather pizza. How's that going for you? How's that treating you? I don't remember what it was. It's garbage, whatever it was. All right. I think that's chat, right? That's everybody in chat. Let's see. So we've got Gary Johnson, Jeb Bush, Ben Carson, Condoleezza Rice. We got anybody else who's got a vote for a candidate? I will give it 10 seconds plus lag, so that's like 16 seconds. 10, 9. This is kind of fun. I'm intrigued to see where this goes. I think we'll probably have to continue this next week and see if we can actually win. All right, I think that's everybody. So we've got, we're just gonna do from top to bottom. Gary Johnson's gonna be 1, Jeb Bush is 2, Ben Carson is 3, and Condoleezza Rice is 4. I've got a trusty D4 right here. So you can see whatever number shows up on the top. It's not gonna focus, is it? Whatever. Anyway, I'll tell you what number it is, and that will be who we're running against. We have a 4. We are running against Condoleezza Rice. Remember, Chim, when this happens, if Condoleezza Rice becomes president, this was your fault. All right, let's get this started. Game versus Rice. No, that was cool. Oh, that was cool. Oh, shoot. I wish that it had taken the screenshot before that. I'm gonna fix some stuff. Hold on. I should have read that. That was not smart. All right, so we're gonna save the game real quick. And we're gonna do this. We're gonna see if we can jump back here real quick. New game. All that's fine. And our custom character, Intelli Game. And we're running against Condoleezza Rice. Well, that took a lot less time. I want that loading screen is what I want. I want a screenshot of that loading screen. Whatever, that's all right. We'll get one another time. Win the states, win the election. So we can see that based on the color, it'll tell us how likely we are to get it. Select your candidate, then right click on a state to move there. Then you get to take action in that state. Raise your awareness in each state. No awareness equals no vote. Match your stance on issues to win like-minded voters. Looks like there's fundraising, building headquarters, endorsements, and operatives. All right, so we're starting in Oregon, which is a super blue state. We don't have to worry about that a whole lot. We could start by moving to Washington, or we can head straight into red territory. Let's see. According to the stats here, it's 52% Democratic, 11% undecided, and 37% Republican. It's a somewhat wealthy state. We haven't held a fundraiser here yet. It's got 7 electoral votes. Apparently, their their top issues are legalization of marijuana, the environment, and supporting green jobs, which sounds about right. All right, so let's see. We hit the swing states. Let's go to the Rust Belt. So we can start. Let's start by going to... I feel like Ohio is going to be a thing, right? Ohio is always a thing. What is that? A Rice Outreach Center. And that's Rice Election Headquarters. It looks like we've got an election headquarters maybe behind my giant head. All right, so let's go to... You want to go to the Rust Belt? Let's do that. Let's go down here to Oklahoma. Yeah, we're going to start here. Oh, or we could go to Arkansas where we have Black Lives Matter on the platform. I say we start here. Are you going to let me... Your opponent opposes... Yeah, I believe that. Wait, which one has the best match? I'm not sure, and we're still trying to figure out even what it is that we're supposed to do on a turn. So, build structures that give bonuses each turn. You need these bonuses to win. So we can get endorsements from outreach centers, we can get operatives from consulting offices, and we can get money from campaign headquarters. So we can upgrade our campaign headquarters. That'll give us a $30,000 bonus. But it looks like it costs us 500 large and some energy. So instead, let's give a speech. Talk is cheap, but takes lots of stamina. Hold a rally to give a quick boost to your awareness. Oh, sweet. Okay, so we can choose a campaign speech. Securing the borders, national anthem pro... Oh! Alright. So I think we should go ahead and start on that black platform and give a national anthem protest speech. We get a charisma bonus and a little bit of an appearance bonus too, which we obviously... So then we can choose, are we talking about favoring it or are we talking about how our opponent is against it? Apparently we also get a credibility bonus, but... I just like am not down with, is there one that has, oh, election integrity gives us 3 thumbs up. Like, it's interesting because I'm already sitting here thinking, like, I want to talk about what I do instead of spending a whole bunch of time trashing the opponent for what they do. All right, so let's talk about election integrity. All right, so that tilts them a little bit more. All right, have a good night, Eric. Thanks for swinging by the stream. Hope you had a good time. And yeah, have a good night. Opponent opposes election integrity. So let's start trying to flip some swing states. Can we move? Because I do want to move. We've got four stamina left. It looks like we can create some adds. Not enough stamina. Okay. What if we hit turn? Okay, so see, Condoleezza moved. How's Condoleezza moving and doing all that stuff? And I am not. I want to fly. Electoral votes, state wealth, awareness. Create, build a headquarters. See, how did you get to move? This shouldn't be that hard to figure out. Auto save, turns before auto saving. Snap back when rotating. Yeah, this shouldn't be difficult. Didn't it just say to right click on the state and then you could move to it? That doesn't seem to be the way this is working, unless my right click is broken. It's not. Let's build a headquarters. No, see, because it's going to try and build it in Oregon, and I don't want it in Oregon. I need to move to another state. We need to get active. Not enough clout to win any available endorsements. All right, we're gonna save this real quick. And then because we're gonna quit and come back and see if. Oh, there's a tutorial. Oh, they even tell you about the Electoral College. If you are playing this game not in the United States and don't understand the clusterfuck that is the American electoral system, well, here's a quick tutorial. Let's see. So, home base, new headquarters construction. Let's see, there was a planning map option on the bottom. Well, we can try it. I'm okay with that. Load game. Travel to states and make them blue to win their votes. Select your candidate, then right-click on a state to move there. Okay, so maybe my candidate was not highlighted already. That's the one. Okay. All right, and apparently it takes a little bit of stamina to be able to make a move. So let's do. Looks like Nevada is pretty. Pretty broke. How can you be against reducing unemployment? Why would you do that? All right, so if we're gonna pull in here, let's talk about. Let's oppose the emails. That seems like a good idea. Give a speech on that. And create some ads. Ads are expensive, but boost your issue ratings over time. Media outlet, either ground game or via TV. Looks like the ground game is a whole lot cheaper. Changes your position on an issue. State change 3, national change 2. Why is the Black Lives Matter symbol a gun? Like, couldn't it have just been like black people? Or did it have to be a, you know what? All right, whatever. Intelligame supports Black Lives Matter. Yep, let's run the ad. Do it. All right, and we are out of energy. Really, you're gonna go to California? What are you doing? What is that? That is a ground game ad. Okay. And we've got a TV ad here. All right. So we're going to... All right. Let's go to Wisconsin. We know how that ended. All right. So we are going to go here. And we're going to build a headquarters. Campaign HQ brings in a steady stream of cash. Without these structures, you'll quickly go broke. Consulting offense generates political capital used to hire operatives who are key to winning battleground states. An outreach center generates PR clout. Consulting office probably sounds good then. One political capital per week. How much money do we have right now? $1.7 million. That's what it takes to start this game. However much we've spent... Probably what? Then we started with like 2 million? Gosh. Let's see. I think it takes 3 stamina to make an ad. Yeah, it takes 3 stamina. So we can move to another place. Why are we building in Wisconsin? Because, I mean, look at what happened in the actual election. Like, yeah, Wisconsin, Ohio, like, Florida. We gotta have a strong game there. Let's go to what is a Colorado looks pretty safe. Maybe we should hit Minnesota because we're here anyway, right? Or Iowa? Iowa's also a swing state. It's kind of poor. We should go to Illinois and get money. That's what we should do. Fundraising. Well known in a wealthy state, fundraise there for big bucks. let's see. Current funds, $1.27 million. State wealth is $466 million. National approval, 44%. State awareness, 8%. We should probably do some work here before trying to raise funds. So we should... We can oppose the Dakota Access Pipeline. Oh, that's interesting that they say that independents are not for that. Election integrity. Changes your position on an issue, state change one. How do you not support fighting ISIS? All right, so we're going to go with... opposing the Dakota Access Pipeline. That sounds worthwhile. All right, where do we want to go next, folks? Looks like Condi just headed down to Texas and built... couple of resources, a ground game ad and an election HQ. Looks like we've got some support here in Illinois, which is good. Oh, there's still Alaska and Hawaii to think about too. How are we feeling, folks? Do we have a place that we want to head to? It's strange trying to think about actual political strat. Who is this? Hollywood friend raises opponent's awareness in a state by 3% each week. Of course, you would build in North Texas. Yeah, they're so it seems like Texas is becoming increasingly purple. Or at least that's the way it sounds. Is that in the South then, like Austin and other stuff like that? Virginia. Okay. That's cool. We got this little news thing. I was gonna say, if it's not gonna play music, we're gonna find some. All right, let's head to Virginia, folks. And let's see if I can find Virginia on a map. This is West Virginia, so that's Virginia. There we go. Wow, even Houston is blue now? That's kind of exciting, honestly. I would love to see the actual like election numbers to see if they are predicting that that Texas will be a swing state by 2020, because that's a huge amount of a pretty huge number of electoral votes that would be up for grabs. The House of Cards soundtrack. I could look and see if we could find it. That would be kind of interesting. Instead of listening to the same track over and over. See if it's on YouTube. House of Cards season one full soundtrack. Man, this has got a lot of commercials in it. All right, and we're gonna shut this music off real quick. Yeah, cilantro is still terrible, folks. All right, so we're in Virginia. Why don't we go ahead and set up an HQ here? The Patreon doesn't link doesn't work. Oh. That's weird. Let me check that out real quick. Thanks for looking at that, Fluff. This is strange. IG, Patreon, copy. Let me get that Nightbot action real quick. The period. Oh, the period gets caught with the hyperlink. Okay, good call. Come on, Nightbot. You can do better than this. All right, let's check this one, see if it works. There it goes. Cool. Can we get Nightbot a bow? Yeah, that's actually a command. There will be a bow one day. There will be a bow one day. It's like Chim just unlocked like a secret Nightbot feature. I'm gonna have to put in other ones just so that there's something to hunt for. Don't spam the bow though. Don't spam the bow. How's everybody's how's today been? Is there something positive about today you want to share? This the generic like how's everybody's week been is not really a great question, but like do you have like a highlight or something that you're excited about that you want to share with folks? Just wait for Pete. Yeah, you'll have to get Pete Flan in here though. I don't know where he is. Have you two actually like tried to catch up in DC at all? Ads are expensive but boost your issue ratings over time. Let's give a speech here. I want to try and get some influence so that we can start start doing some fundraisers. Supports religious freedom. I don't even know what that. Fighting ISIS, a strong military. So these are the issues in Virginia. All right. Can Black Bat and I get mod stat? I feel like this is a petition to try and get. I feel like this is just a petition to start messing with. To start messing with the mod commands. Okay, so we'll think on it. We'll think on it. You are here all the time though, and it is helpful to have more moderators. I'll actually put together and figure out like what the essentially commands for mods are. And if folks are interested in being a moderator, you should definitely you should reach out in the Intelligame Discord. And we'll figure out how to put that together. For folks who are looking for that, it is here. That's weird that you're gonna like hear me talk about that after I put the link, but whatever. All right, so let's run an ad. And we're gonna support, let's see, if we're in Virginia, supporting religion. See, there are people here, right? Black Lives Matter had to be a gun, but religious freedom, that was people. And a bunch of white people, but whatever. Let's oppose Confederate flag display. All right, no, you know what? No. We're in Virginia. We're in the battleground. We're going to favor supporting gay marriage. Oh, thank you for that donation, Fluff. That's awesome. Thank you so much for helping to keep Intelligame strong and running. It means a lot. So, thank you for that $5. That was really cool. And we press on. We push forward. It's been really cool, by the way, to see all the support that has gone into. Getting the Patreon and getting the fundraising. It's been really awesome. So thank you for that. Let's see. Why is gay marriage an eagle? I'm really not sure. I have no idea. Intelligame supports supporting gay marriage as opposed to Intelligame opposes. Yeah. Okay, let's run some ground game here. And we've got 5 stamina left. Let's do a... We should build a base here of some kind. Let's get an... Outreach centers generate PR clout used to secure vital special interest endorsements. Upgrade them to quickly get multiple endorsements and big nationwide bonuses. Let's build an outreach center. That sounds cool. Try and establish sort of our base in the south. And it looks like we've got 1 stamina left, so we can move to another state. We should head to... I want to lock down the coast. I don't like the idea that she's in Washington. But let's put some stuff in Texas. Let's fight here. Because it's 41%, 47%. Like, gay marriage is supposed to be patriotic, but a lot of our patriarchs in office don't even support it. Yeah, how do you put a flag on that? Like, I would love to know like how people have come up with the like logos and the design behind some of this stuff. Click operatives to cash in your points. Oh, whoa. All right, so apparently now we've built up enough political capital that we can bring in. Interesting that, why are all the operatives white folks? Anybody, nobody said anything about that? I want to share the wiki page about, there's a wiki page? I'm not familiar. No, are you leaving, Black Bat? I understand if you gotta go. But yeah, you could. You'd just be like, hey, let's order pizza and watch the Spawn on Me stream at 7:30. I think it's gonna be lit. I'm excited about it. But I also understand if you have to leave. So she laid on the full guilt trip. Oh no. Well, I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do, I guess. Her presence in a state will result in a weekly plus 4% to the candidate's awareness. Cost one political capital a week. A smear merchant? Fast on the draw with well-timed quips and chuckles. The smear merchant will attack their opponent with humorous books and writings, each filled to the brim with cutting remarks, decreasing the opponent's ratings by 15%. What? Ryan Silo tried to steal eggs? What? Is that in Slime Rancher? Oh, no. This is about penguins. Whoa. I had no idea. Let's get the consultant. Let's work here in Texas. We can get some stuff going here. And if we check the news, we see what Condoleezza did last time. Uses HQ in Texas to try and swing voter support. Got advertisements in Texas. All right. That's good. Rice eating games dust after first weeks of campaign. Check that out. Yeah. All right. Have a good one, Black Bat. I hope you have some fun. And you should, if you're going to eat some pizza for me. I kind of want to order a pizza. That sounds good. Bolting like a hungry cougar out of the starting gates. Be happy for Black Bat for hanging out with friends, Chim. That's what we gotta do. Yeah. What do you like on your pizza? Ooh, that's a real question. Is this gonna be part of my political platform? Do I have to allocate points to this? So I am one of those people who likes like non-traditional stuff. I'm barbecue, ranch, chicken. That is a delicious pizza to me. Also, I had a mac and cheese pizza once that was like amazing. And also breakfast pizza where you have gravy and then eggs and you threw me off there. So you have like gravy and then eggs or hash brown potatoes and then eggs and like sausage or bacon. Breakfast pizza, so good. Oh, what's up, Julia Alice? Welcome to the stream. It's good to see you. And yes, taco pizza is fantastic. And Fluff, you need to have ranch and pizza. That is the way it is done. That is delicious. You should do that really soon. Like your next stream, you should have ranch and pizza. If I miss anything from Madison, yeah, the mac and cheese pizza was hot. It was fire. I miss it. Mac and cheese pizza with hot peppers would actually be really good too, because like mac and cheese pizza usually is kind of bland. Experts are quick to urge Game not to get cocky. Don't dismiss Rice yet. With both candidates just getting started, it's much too early to predict a winner. At the Game camp, staff members are thrilled with the early results. Rice can kiss my Democrat butt, one intoxicated staff member exclaimed during a campaign party. In my eyes, she's already lost. Like I've been saying, you just don't mess president to be Intelligame. That's cool. We're saving that. I'm a big fan of chicken pizza with buffalo. Oh, buffalo chicken's a good one too. I used to not really like buffalo sauce. I think it was like the vinegar or something, but nah, it's good. What are other favorite pizzas in the chat? We've got some pineapple. Or you could put any other things on it, Chim? Or is it just pineapple? And taco pizza is super good, especially with sour cream. You have to get the parts of sour cream. Sour cream makes pretty much anything better. All right. Condoleezza Rice has won the endorsement of the National Foreign Policy Committee. Fighting ISIS plus 10, Iranian nuclear deal minus 5. Dang. Okay. I feel like we might be behind right now. We might have to get some work going. Okay, so we've got our consultant here working for us in Texas. We've got a full set of stamina. We've got some political capital and some clout. Built outreach centers to build clout. So let's put an outreach center. Let's get up here in New England. Where's New York? That's New York, right? Let's get an outreach center here. I have no idea whether or not this is actually going to be helpful. Where am I? Oh, you can build stuff places where you aren't. You don't actually have to fly there. Okay. I really thought I had flown there, though. We are low on money, too. We should fly here and see if we can get a fundraiser going since they've got a lot of money and they kind of like us. $138K. I guess that's something. Fan of the deluxe Hawaiian ham or chicken, bacon, pineapple, red pepper. I'm down with bacon on a pizza, but it's got to be crispy bacon. The whole like Canadian bacon or ham or whatever. Like I'm not playing that game. I like crispy bacon. I think Fluff knows that though. The very breakfast themed chat. Also, per usual, I always shout this out, but if you are heading over to other Twitch streams, you should be following Fluffy Pancake XO, because she's got a really awesome stream and a really great community. I've actually found a number of other streamers from hanging out there that I've really enjoyed. Just Everest is also super cool. Like, yeah, that's good people. We've only got one stamina left, so I guess we can stay here and try and run another fundraiser. No, let's head to Washington. I want to lock down the coast. Raise your awareness and issue ratings. What was that? Campaign speech on gun rights. Candidate drew a reasonably sized crowd and did a good job getting both her message and her name into the mind of the voters. Oof, this could be getting kind of rough. It's good for a different set of pizza. I can give you that. All right, so what is this? What is later show? It's an interview? I'm down with that. Do we have to fly back there? Or did we do that last time? Let's find out. You've been invited to appear on The Later Show with Stephen Coldcut. This show follows a typical late-night show format, though Coldcut has retained much of the satirical edge he's employed on his past show. His audience generally skews liberal. Also, don't let the comedy fool you. Coldcut knows his stuff. Yep. All right, here we go. We're going on the Coldcut show, folks. Aw, look at Stephen Coldcut. Tonight on The Later Show, I turn down yet another request to be someone's running mate. The climate is changing, unless it isn't, but it is. Should we declare war on the climate? Wow. I bet he's a ham. Oh, y'all are terrible. He might be a turkey, though. Let's see. We need to act now. America cannot act alone. The weather is unpredictable as the tides, and I'm not convinced by the science. This isn't even a question. All right, we need to act now. Are we losing the war on terror? Bin Laden was shot in the face, and I know I saw some banner that said mission accomplished, but there's been attacks in Paris and Australia and California, and it seems like we're not making any progress at all. What should we do about it? The war on terror will continue. We're not losing, but we have to remain vigilant. It's a sham to call it a war. There's no one nation to defeat or a dictator to remove. It's a war without end. We must always protect ourselves, but calling it a war made it too easy to lie to ourselves about what it really entails or costs us. We need to invade countries that shelter terror. It will probably never truly be over. Or nope, we kicked butt. Nope, we totally kicked terrorist butt. We're good now. But we need to make sure that we are sure about our targets in the future. We must be certain that in fighting terrorism, we don't become terrorists ourselves. I feel like these are both really good answers. This is hard. I think it's this one. I think this is where we're going, folks. You got 5 seconds if somebody wants to chime in. Nope, too late. All right, we're going. That's it for The Later Show. Tune in next week to see me decide live on air who will be the next president. I wonder if the needle moves based on the speed. So like if we had answered faster, if we would have gotten more needle movement. Brave answers on The Later Show impresses. Or if maybe it was like one overall timer. And so, like, we could have answered more questions if we'd been speedier. I don't know. Ooh, looks like there's an interview opportunity here, but it's a red one. Oh, that says interview for Condoleezza Rice. All right, well, never mind then. I guess I won't go there. What are you? Political opportunity. I want to see if we can find it. Are you going to let me do something there? An old money man has stepped up to support Intelligame, helping the presidential hopeful connect with his rich, wealthy pals in whichever state he's posted in. Raises your fundraising potential in target state by 25%. Oh, dope. All right. Well, let's make some ads here. Let's see. What are the issues here? Are Black Lives Matter, election integrity, and fighting ISIS. And we're good on Black Lives Matter real well. So let's give a speech. Takes a bunch of stamina. We're not going to be able to do anything after that, are we? If we build an HQ, it's going to cost 4 stamina. We don't have enough time to do both. Fundraising takes 3 stamina. And creating ads takes 3 stamina. So let's give a speech here. Get some more awareness. Get some issues out there. And let's talk about, yeah, we do need more states. We got to do some work. Let's do a counter here on Black Lives Matter. Oh, we got it gray, folks. There we go. Looks like Condi just stayed and worked in Alabama. Did an advertisement in fighting ISIS. All right, Fluff. Well, thanks for hanging out. We're going to jump over to the Spawn on Me podcast at 7:30, which I think you'll really enjoy too. So, but yeah, enjoy the cleaning. And thanks for hanging out and for the donation. That was super awesome. It's really cool to have your support, especially as a streamer that I super respect. So. All right. Let's see. We've got a full stamina bar. We've got 6 clout. We can actually hire another operative. We need some endorsement center action. Why aren't you? Oh, that's another consultant. Oh, the consultant flew to Texas. Oh. Okay. So that's what happened. Because I wanted an HQ here. Okay, so that's going to build it in Tennessee. So we need to fly us to New York and build an outreach center. Jim, that the music, the House of Cards soundtrack, that was a good call. This is working real well. All right, so I don't really see any opportunities floating around on the map a whole lot. And it looks like we've super locked down Oregon, which is good. I want to head back. I want to head to Iowa. Iowa's always a big deal. It's going to be a rough state for us because we are not really for many of these things. Missouri, apparently, supporting gay marriage is a big issue there. Black Lives Matter. Yeah. Let's get Missouri galvanized. Let's get some folks paying attention here. Let's create some ads, which will cost us some money, but that's okay. God, I really, the idea that this is a gun, I'm just like, for real, folks, like, whatever. All right, so let's create an ad. And that'll take some time. That's okay. We can get some operatives. Advertisement guru. Advertisements with a 75% price cut in maintenance in whichever state he's working out of. That's kind of nice. All of these folks are shady, though. Let's save the political capital. Gosh, I can only imagine, like, seeing Missouri go blue just for a second. That must have been nice. Won the endorsement of the Christian Confederation. We don't have, like, any endorsements. Build outreach centers to earn points for winning endorsements. Okay. PR clout is 9. Oh, wow. Look at all these that are... Okay, so apparently some of them are already locked down. Cost 0. So is that... Maybe that's the stance you have to have to be able to take it on? The National Civil Liberties Union? Christian Confederation? Oh, maybe you can't... Oh, because it's already been taken. So we can't win it. It's 0 because we can't take it. All right, well, National Organization for the Support of Colored People, National Civil Liberties Union. Yeah, let's take the NCLU. That fits our platform. There we go. And do you feel like the climate in Missouri is shifting a bit? Do you feel like it's... I mean, with all of the discussion that has taken place around particularly, you know, police brutality and the amount, you know, the number of incidences that we've seen highlighted in the media, it seems like it would only be natural that some sort of tonal shift would take place, at least in St. Louis. I don't know about rural Missouri, but... All right, we're getting low on money. can give a speech here on reducing the wealth gap. That definitely for And let's do another fundraiser here in Oregon, because or in Illinois, because we are getting broke. Oh, we have not enough energy for that. Whoops. We're gonna go to California, get some awareness there, and head into back into Texas and get some awareness here. And we'll hire a. We've only got 7 political capital. I do want to upgrade one of these centers. Candidates choose their running mates this week. Now that the campaign has reached the halfway point, the time has come for each candidate to choose a running mate. Wow. Yeah, Missouri has the same problem as the country at large. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, that's kind of the big question is how do you bridge that divide between rural and urban centers? And for me, you know, a big part of it is that, like, living in these rural spaces where you have strong communities that are built, but they're, you know, more insulated to some of the changes and situations that are taking place in the world at large, and in these places, in these urban centers where people from all sorts of different kinds of communities and backgrounds are coming together and learning how to integrate their cultures. More often than not, you know, I feel like a lot of the reason why people would talk about, well, the problem with racism is that you're bringing it up and you're making it a problem, is because it was forcing people to assimilate into dominant, aka white culture. So there weren't problems. If you would just fit into white culture, then everything would be okay. But now that we're saying, like, I shouldn't have to conform to majority culture to be respected, to have the things that I can bring to the table be appreciated, to potentially enrich your culture. Look at the ways that media has taken on so many different things from minority cultures over decades, right? I mean, blues and hip hop and jazz, like, even just looking at those and the ways that those fields evolved, borrowing or stealing generally from black culture, you know, and we can look at the ways that, like, gaming is shifting as we're giving people from marginalized backgrounds opportunities to create games that give us new experiences. Tacoma is a game that centers around 6 characters, none of which are straight white guys. And, like, the amount of representation that that provides, the importance of having characters that are just living and doing their jobs, but also happen to be, you know, LGBT or a person of color or whatever. Like, that's super important. So, yeah, I don't know. We'll have to see what happens. But yeah, I'm sure that the city still has issues, but I'm sure that there are good people there. Yeah. I'm sorry, Barack Obama's going to be our running mate. That's the way that's going to happen. Oh, what's up, Radnor? It's good to see you. Also, congrats on the new work. That's super awesome. I'm really excited for you. Let's see. Yeah, Barack Obama is going to be our running mate. Or we could run with Michelle. Like, Barry had his time. Is he telling me to pick Michelle? Is that what we're saying? You see all that? He might be telling us to pick Michelle. How are we feeling, folks? We can pick a Democratic running mate. Lincoln Chaffee? I don't even know who that is. So apparently from Rhode Island. Martin O'Malley, Michael Bloomberg. Yeah, you came in at a good time, Radnor. We're actually going to be shifting over in just a couple minutes here over to watch the Spawn on Me podcast. We're going to host them and check out an interview that they're doing with Austin Walker from Waypoint. So I think that's going to be a really good show. I'm gonna be really disappointed if they mute this VOD. Like, I'm gonna be really upset. I hope they don't, but we'll see. All right, I think we are gonna run with Michelle. Michelle deserves her chance. I love that they gave her a 9 for her appearance, and damn straight, woman is gorgeous. 9 for media bias, they absolutely love her. Hey Prom, it's good to see you. Welcome to the stream. It's nice to see you over here. And a whole bunch of minority appeal. We are playing the political machine. We just spent 11 weeks running our candidate Intelli Game for president. I think Michelle Obama, your running weight is used to give awareness bonuses to the state they're in and all nearby states. All right, sweet. So you're starting in Illinois, but you should go here. There we go. Yeah, and we did spend an hour creating the character. That was fun, though. Let's be real. That was super fun. We enjoyed it. Texas has got a decent amount of money. I could use some. Do we have an ad still running here? It doesn't look like it. Let's get some TV ads. They're expensive, but we need it. Abortion rights also is a white family. And that's not going to help us a whole lot in Texas. We should talk about, maybe if we talk about reducing the wealth gap, that seems like a good idea. People in Texas want jobs, right? And we're going to hire a advertisement guru so that this gets super cheap. We're gonna flip Texas. That's our game. Ooh, look at that. We seem to have wrapped up Nevada. So I think we can stop the campaign ad here. That's gonna be kind of a drain on our finances. And in the meantime, let's. Hey, buddy. We're gonna go to. We're starting to secure this kind of northeast area. Let's go up to Maine. I think this is Maine, right? This looks like an interesting game. Yeah, so every election, Stardock, the folks who do galactic civilization, that kind of thing, they release an election simulator called the Political Machine. And so they actually release the game before the political election, or before the presidential election, and they release patches to the game based on situations that have played out in real politics to try and like make it feel like a realistic simulation of the game or of actual US political election. Of course, the I don't know how the simulation in this game runs for the whole Trump versus Clinton thing, but we weren't willing to even entertain a concept where we could end up with Trump elected again, so we're running against Condoleezza Rice. Yep. Was that the whole? Are we out of music? Nope, there it is. Okay. Let's build. I feel like we need a base to fight here in Ohio. Ohio is a critical swing state, but so is Michigan. So let's run an ad up here. We'll run a ground game ad on. We know that Black Lives Matter is a strong point for us, so we're going to do that. And then we are going to hit up. Ohio. We're going to fight here. Game continues to lead in polls. A good choice. Too bad we didn't do that in the real world. Yeah. You ain't wrong. Keeping a fair distance between himself and his appointment and his opponent, Intelli Game has continued to reign supreme in the polls through the first half of the election cycle. We can only hope this trend continues right through election night. Over at the Condoleezza Rice camp, political consultants are working overtime to find a chink in Game's armor. We still have half of the campaign to bring our numbers up. We're all optimistic and our message is a good one. While visiting Georgia, Condoleezza Rice took some extra time to express her views on repealing Obamacare. Garbage. All right, and we gave a talk on reducing the wealth gap. Yeah, we did some work, folks. Well, it is 7:20, so that means that we're going to be swinging on over to the Spawn on Me podcast in just a minute. I'm going to go ahead and save this. And we will I think we're going to come back to this next week. Now that we've got sort of a sense of rhythm and how the game works, it looks like we are really behind in Ohio. It's going to take us some serious work to battle that back. But we've got Oregon pretty much on lock. I think we've got some good resources to put up a fight here in Texas. We've actually got the majority in Texas right now. New York is super locked down, and so is Illinois. So we've got a pretty large number of Electoral College votes. We've got some of these small states that are going to be hard to fight for. We should probably jump into this sort of southeastern tip of the country when we come back. But for now, that is the political machine. I hope you folks enjoyed it. That's actually pretty much the most time I've ever played it. There's actually DLC. I probably don't want it. Like, what could you possibly give me in terms of DLC? The campaign DLC. It's got mixed reviews. Hey, thanks for that follow, Prom. It's good to have you as part of the Intelligame community, especially coming from Fluffstream. That's pretty awesome. All right. I'm not actually going to be on the podcast. We're just going to hang out in the chat I appreciate that, Prom. We're actually going to host Spawn on Me, so I would encourage you, if you're going to hang out until our usual 9 o'clock time slot, that you actually slide on over with me over to Spawn on Me, because I'll be hanging out there and watching it. And really, you're going to give me a League of Legends ad? Like, I don't know what that game is. Okay. I just want this ad done. Please stop. I know how the game works. I would encourage you, if you're going to be hanging around for a bit or you've got some time, let's go over there and watch them together. And if not, totally cool. Thanks for hanging out. It was awesome seeing you. Don't forget that if you want to become part of our new Patreon, you can swing on over to patreon.com/letsintelligame. The link is there in the chat. But I totally appreciate all the support that you folks have given. And to those of you who have already jumped in as patrons, thank you. This has been a really awesome opportunity, and I'm looking forward to more. Anyway, we're going to go on break for just a little bit, a couple minutes to grab some water and whatnot, and then we'll be back to watch some Spawn on Me. All right, folks, we are back and we're hanging out for just a little bit before Spawn and Me kicks off. You've heard me talk about him quite a few times, but I'm really excited to see how this goes down, honestly. I've been spending a lot more time looking at Waypoint over the past few weeks, partly because, you know, as somebody who also runs a game website, I'm trying to figure out like, what can I be doing better? But also because Waypoint is not afraid to take a side and to have these discussions about race and politics and gender and all these different things that we talk about and Intelligame as well. I think this will be a really great discussion, and I'm looking forward to sharing it with you folks. Also, I want to call out Sartagus and Moose T187. Thank you both for your follows. Welcome to the Intelligame crew. It's really awesome to see you. And also, I noticed the notifications for Prom's follow and Fluffy's donation repopped. So thank you for those as well. And I also would vote for Intelli. So that's super cool. I need to actually make it so that you can better see the text that's put in on the donation. So I will work on that for next time. Anyway, man, can we not be with the like somber, dour House of Cards? Because that was breaking my heart. I hope you folks enjoyed the game, by the way. I think it's a really interesting kind of board game-esque, you know, political simulator. And I'm hoping, I think there were a lot of things to kind of take away from the experience. There were obviously some design questions, you know, making Black Lives Matter represented by a gun, abortion rights and traditional values represented by, you know, a 2.4 child white family. You know, there are some interesting things in there, but in general, I also think there are, I think there are some interesting places where it makes statements about what it means to work inside the political realm. And it'll be interesting to see what the efficacy is of some of our tactics and speeches and things as the game goes on. Let's see, it's a pretty interesting game. Is it on Steam or published independently? So it's made by Stardock. It is available on Steam. Let me grab the link for it real quick. But I'm not sure if you can get it DRM free. I'm sure you could. The website is here. And actually, if you owned the political machine, if you owned the 2012 political machine, you could have updated for $5 instead of. And it looks like if you can buy it direct from the Stardock website, and it looks like you can also go to Steam or Green Man Gaming and pick up a code that way. And they also did some campaign DLC. Show me the features. There's a new ladder mode. Choose your side and take the nation by storm as you campaign against members of the opposite party. Okay, so then you can basically, it's like a fighting game tournament where you go against each progressive member. New historical candidates and challenges. So it's a interesting game. Yeah, pretty deep for $10. Absolutely. They've had this essentially same game. I believe their first political machine was released in 2008. So I think they've essentially been reskinning the game each new election. But it's a pretty compelling game. So I would give it a shot. We're going to toss in some music while we're waiting for Spawn on Me to get up and running and see if they have gotten going yet. Nope, looks like they're still running, still hosting another notch, so we'll give it just a little bit. What have you been playing, Prom? What's been going on in the chat lately? Have anybody been playing anything interesting? I think the one of the things that was really interesting about what's up, Academical? Welcome to the stream. One of the things that's really interesting about the political machine is that it was weird making decisions about what I wanted to talk about based on where I was. And generally, you know, that's how any conversation works, right? Like, you may have an opinion, but you're surrounded by a bunch of people who'd hate the opinion. So you're like, maybe I shouldn't really talk about it right now. But when we have those particular campaign topics that we can bring up, for instance, say in Texas, it's like, well, we could have talked about abortion rights because that was part of our platform, but that probably wouldn't sail super well or get us a lot of influence in Texas. So maybe we should talk about something that's a little more useful there. And thinking about each state as sort of its own zone with its own specific priorities was kind of a cool discussion. So yeah, playing PUBG. I one day, I'm pretty sure I will take the plunge and buy PUBG. It seems like a lot of folks have been really into that. Prom's been playing chill games like Stardew Valley. That's a good call. And have you played Yonder? We played a little bit of Yonder Cloudcatcher Chronicles. And it was fun. I really liked it. I'm going to spend more time with it. It's got some UI problems, but it's a really nice kind of chill game like Stardew. Or I guess Fluffy's been playing Slime Rancher. And that's kind of a cool game. Let's see. Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. I still really want to play that, Radnor. I've heard nothing but great things about it, and that it's kind of a short but positive experience game. So I would love to spend some time with that. I'll have to keep an eye out for your stream. If you're gonna run through it again, I'd love to see it. Whoa, that's a big statement. Best game ever. Wow. Yeah, some members of my family, I just feel like anything slightly political is a conversational landmine. I think a lot of people go through that. I can admit that, like, in my family, most of us are Black or have a lot of Black family members, right? So some of those political conversation spaces are not as difficult to have because there's a lot of similarity. But I do, I have an uncle who I'm not sure if he actually voted for Trump, but there were a couple of times where he even brought up just like, you know, that Trump, he's a good businessman. And I was like, we're going to have to shut this conversation down. And a part of me kind of wishes that I hadn't done that. I mean, given his one vote, I mean, and he's a Black man, like he didn't marry into the family. Well, he did marry into the family, but a part of me feels like I should have been willing to have that conversation, because they're the kind of conversations that we need to have with the people who are close to us and who can hopefully respect who we are as people. But yeah, who wants to be that person who tanks Thanksgiving, you know? It's hard. It's really hard. So I totally get where you're coming from there. At least with us, we only had the one, you know? Okay, it looks like they have, Fluffy is picking up cat slimes and throwing them into incinerators. She's got, I think Fluff's got an edge to her that we don't fully appreciate. But yeah, it's funny when she gets triggered, she's Fluff triggered, it's pretty funny. Yeah, I didn't expect Radnor for there to be as much hype around Hellblade. I saw it at the Unreal preview during GDC, not last year, but the year before. And then I thought it just kind of faded into the ether. So at some point in time, I will spend some time with it. I'm really excited about spending some more focused time going through games that have strong stories and experiences. I've been kind of blowing time playing Tetris and that kind of stuff, so... Oddly enough, my mother is the one that went vaguely cult-like over Trump when she'd been a Democrat. That's wow. I wouldn't have expected those kinds of flips. Any particular reason why? And yeah, academical. I see where you're coming from. And I agree that each of us has a sort of role to play, right? And some of us are really good at being out on the front lines and like having those discussions and taking somebody head on and saying, yeah, how can you vote for somebody who, mocks disabled people and, all of those kinds of things and has those conversations head on? I don't know. I feel like to a certain extent, I wonder if there's a certain amount outside of our comfort zone, not far outside of our comfort zone, but where do we reach? Where do we have that potential for influence where it takes us a little bit more? And I don't think that means that everybody has to go in and have the tough conversation with the family member who's dogmatically X. But I do think that perhaps more than I should have said, like, we all need to have those conversations. Just we all need to recognize where we can use our influence and our positivity and make something good and make something better. Good point, academical. And let's see. I think they're almost set. I just saw them update their channel info. I just lost the IG chat. Because I refreshed the wrong thing. No, don't do that. That's not what I want. Apparently, the tick is coming back. Yeah, I don't know, Prom. The idea that like there are folks out there that are just I don't know how to stop that, right? Other than essentially just every time, how do I hang around enough to say that like, yep, every time this shows up, like you've this is a problem and that's not how this is done, and let me, Facebook debate everything. It seems like it's infrequently that I can get somebody to actually change their position. But it must have been really intense to watch that shift happen, particularly if she used to be someone who was on the side of light. Yeah, academical, there is a certain amount of I think that, it's I think we had a discussion about this before that sociology provides tools about how humans work. And it, in many ways is probably the book of cheat codes. It's just a question of do you use those cheat codes ethically? So let's see. Are they? I don't think they're live yet. Dang it, I keep hitting the refresh button and it's refreshing the chat. And then since it's the chat pop out, I lose all the chat. So if somebody has like posted something. No. So if somebody has posted something and I haven't talked about it, you should repost it because it's not me trying to ignore you. It's just that I keep pressing F5 on the wrong windows. Let's see. Bought it because I like the way it looked and I love Norse mythology, but it blew me away in the combat and winning in the fights and puzzles. I have looked at virtually nothing for Hellblade because I've heard that it's relatively short and it's also kind of a one-shot deal. Like you don't go back necessarily and play it again. I think you were the one that told me that. So I haven't tried to look up any like videos or anything on it because I don't want any spoilers. It just sounds like such a good game, especially at the $30 price point. Like that's so nice. I'm all for shorter quality experience games right there in that $20, $30 price range. I think we're gonna see more things shift to that angle because like why put in, these 100-hour games when I'm just like I've only got time for like one of them, right? And I don't even have time for one of them. Yeah, I don't know, prompt. Like, I do think that's what ends up happening. And the problem is, I've had a number of discussions about about concepts of media literacy, right? The idea that we have these. When I was in elementary school, and the internet was becoming a thing, we had these discussions about. We had these discussions where we were just like, look, you can't call Wikipedia a source. And that I don't think that that's the case anymore, but at the time it was like nobody's super familiar with Wikipedia. There's not like a big vested interest in making it accurate. We had this idea of when you see something on the internet, you have to vet it. You have to make sure that it's something credible. Just because it's been published and looks pretty doesn't mean that it's reputable. And I think that a lot of folks out there never got that training. And it's not when you come from a space where, anything that's put in print, this is before Amazon came around and said like, hey, let's let anybody print whatever the hell they want to. There's still on-demand printing on a small scale, but more often than not, if you're looking at an encyclopedia or whatever, it's from a publishing house that has gone through and vetted and said, yes, this information is somehow credible, even if it fits whatever their bias is. So we accept it. I think there are a lot of folks out there who are still having that issue of trying to figure out how to figure out whether a source is valid. Hey, Jayzavi, thank you for is that right? Jazavi? Yeah. And they pushed back to 8. I am glad you gave me that heads up. I don't know why I didn't just check the Twitter myself. So yeah, we've got another 10 minutes. And I guess we can just chat for a bit, right? Because any game that I pull up for the next 10 minutes, you know what? No, we're gonna I'm going to we could probably get another couple turns of political machine in. Or we could run, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna run Yonder for 10 minutes. That's what we're gonna do. Let's see. No, be quiet. Please be quiet. All right. There we go. The worst part about it is that the cheat codes only work on people who can be influenced by their community and where the community includes weaknesses that can be accessed. If the community intentionally walls itself off from outside world, there's not a whole lot that you can do without the government or law enforcement resources. I mean, that's totally true, right? I mean, that's the way that it's why media is important, is because media gives us the opportunity to influence perception. But if people have made a conscious effort to cut themselves off from influence, it's kind of like how, like if we look at the Bible, right? And the Bible says, like, lean not on thine own understanding. We have these like situations where when your rhetoric tells you not only to participate, this is the, by the way, rumor, the legendary pink bow that everybody talks about. When you have pieces of your rhetoric that say not only do this, but also don't listen when other people tell you not to do this, when that is already included in the rhetoric. Oh, that's right. They got this backwards. It becomes much harder then to figure out how to handle those situations. I think this is how it goes. That's what we wanted. Okay. Are you? This is weird. I also think there's a problem with the idea of reputable being successfully attacked by purveyors of conspiracy theory, political spin. I mean, it's the... This is still not working the way it's supposed to. I think the x-axis is wrong. There. This is just, like, part of what happens when... You have, yeah, it's meme culture, right? We have this idea that, again, people haven't really been able to tell when a particular source is reputable or is something that you should pay attention to. So everything feels like something you should pay attention to, which means essentially you end up paying attention to nothing. And I think that there are plenty of situations where people have decided that there's actually an episode of, I believe, Hidden Brain, where they talk about how somebody basically, they ran a experiment to figure out if people thought that a sentiment or a statement was more valid if it rhymed, essentially if it was short and it rhymed, and people were more likely to believe that a statement was true if it was short and if it rhymed. And so basically it kind of speaks to this idea that, like, when things are catchy and they seem to kind of make sense, then we just go ahead and buy it, which is why meme culture is so successful and why so many people talk about how they memed the Trump presidency into existence, is because memes are an exceptionally effective way of marketing to the human brain. So I don't know. I don't know how you fix that. Good spot for a stone bridge. Okay, new quest, but I don't know how to make those things. Crafting in this game is not as easy as crafting in Fortnite. Yeah, the more credible the source, clearly the less true it must be. Yeah, and I mean, this is how the entire like CNN is ISIS became a thing. It could become a thing, right? You have these outlets like flipping. Use your words, Josh. You have these outlets like InfoWars. And it's funny because I can actually remember seeing... I can't believe I didn't hit transition. That whole time I've been walking around playing this game and did not... None of you could see it. You were just watching me. Which I appreciate. But yeah, it's like this whole time, you know, I can remember seeing people put signs or put stickers on stop signs that said like InfoWars, and now I'm thinking about it, it's like I wish that meant stop InfoWars, but I can't really guarantee that that's what that meant. But you know, the more that you keep around these not credible news sources, but you increase their production values and you give them a platform, the more that people start to believe, oh well, they must be onto something. It's garbage. Hey, what's up, Randomly? Good to see you. Welcome to the chat. How I hope Dylan, right? How was the tourney? I hate whenever, yeah. It's ultimately why undercover agents exist. Yeah, I mean, this is... Twilight Struggle is a really interesting board game that provides kind of an example of this idea of having multiple opportunities to give input and to find ways to shift people's thinking without, hopefully, without resorting to violence, though sometimes there's nothing as effective as a good political coup. And yeah, this game is Yonder Cloudcatcher Chronicles. It's a sort of pacifist open world exploration crafting game, which I have a really good time with and should change my description to note. Let's see, channel is... Oh. All right, so we are going to... Hold on, let me post it in the chat real quick. Alright, so it is this one. And yeah, it's hella zen. It's super great. Yeah, the when people take particularly satirical sites and make them and write them up as like a and write them up as like actual fact because they haven't looked it over. That makes no sense to me. All right. Well, thank you for that heads up, Zavi. We're going to go ahead and we're going to jump out of Cloudcatcher. We're going to save first for the three items that I harvested. That's fine. And I'm glad. It seems like your kind of game, Fluff. I think you'd really enjoy it. All right, so let's jump on over to Spawn On Me real fast. I'm going to go ahead and give you the follow link here. Thank you, everybody, for hanging out here. If you are, we're just going to participate in the chat over there. I think one of these days I'll end up hosting a, well, actually, let's do it this way instead. Actually, you know what? No, let's head over to Spawn On Me. So if everybody, I'm just going to go ahead and host them there. And if you want to jump over there, we'll continue the chat. I think they're going to have a really great show tonight. So thanks everybody for hanging out. We will see you soon. And also, if you want to jump over there for the chat, that's cool. I will keep the Intelligame chat open as well in case people want to stay here and talk about other things too.